Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Des Bishop!
Maybe I was lucky, but when I came to live in Ireland at 14, I was exempt from learning Irish at school. Lately, however, I've really got a desire to learn the language and see what it is about Irish that has freaked out so many people for so long. So in February 2007, I went to spend 12 months of my life in the Connemara Gaeltacht, the final frontier of Irish life I've yet to explore. I hope not only to learn to speak Irish, but to actually perform the first ever stand-up comedy gig, As Gaeilge. Can I learn the lingo in a year? Can I make them laugh in our native tongue? Here's my story. So we're in Tiernyi. I'm just driving up to the Griffin's house. Anthony Fat Willie, I'm told, is the name of the kind of boss of the house. I'm gonna be living here for the next year. You know, I think they have like a little kind of granny flat upstairs, and it's kind of good because I'll be able to speak Irish to the kids and stuff. Hopefully it's all right.
Oh, hey. Des!
How you doing?
Oh, Kevin, what's up? How are you?
Good, how are you?
Cheers, you're my soul. Hello, I wasn't expecting you so soon.
Oh, yeah, sorry about that.
Come here, let me just show you Gail. This is Gail. Do you want to speak English to your Irish, or...?
Well, everybody says that it's better if you just speak Irish to me all the time, and I'll just struggle through it.
So, okay, would too.
What?
Okay, would too. That means, how are you?
Oh, I'll make a man.
Oh, wait, keep up again. All right, tell the what?
But I am learning Irish a little bit differently to the way a lot of you guys probably learnt it, you know, in that I'm enjoying it.
I love the Fat Willis. Can't get enough of the Fat Willis.
Just seems funny, you know. Unfortunately, this is not the ideal day to be sort of praising Leitir Móir, because this is a great place, but it's quite possibly the most Gaedona day, the most Gaedona Gaedona that Connemara has seen all year. It's tashe flock, tashe an flock, agus an windy as flock. it's just a bad day. So my mission now is to just, you know, do as much as I can within the community. They say this is the best place for people speaking the language, you know. So I'm just going to try to conch as much as I possibly can in the shop, in the GA club, and just basically become a citizen of the area and improve my Irish day by day. Is it okay to train? It is.
More than welcome.
Yeah, because I'm going to be around now for a while, so might as well join the club.
Are you a back or forward or a keeper?
I'd say, well... I'm nothing, to be honest with you, but I'd say a back. Yeah. I can catch a ball and I can get rid of it.
Well, that's the main thing.
That's all I can promise you.
Yeah.
I can catch a ball and get rid of it. It was good, yeah, I enjoyed it. It was good. A little embarrassing at the start because I hadn't soloed a ball and... you know, a long time. But it was good, I got into it. I want to live the dream of being a junior C champion in the GAA. So it's good fun, you know. I just want to get involved, get the everyday bit of language going, playing the football, and, you know, just get to know a few people.
Shawak.
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 Oh! Shawak. So, perfect?
Intoch.
Intoch.
Smile at her shop, yeah?
Intoch.
A walk.
Gets me excited. Kekwil to. Kekwil.
Shiv.
Shiv. Kekwil Shiv.
I was playing a bit of Gaelic football in the Leitir Móir GA club. And, that's right, and I wasn't as good as I wanted to be. But I was better than your average Americanach, you know? So that was a good laugh. I was all right, good laugh. Good mahad. You people are too nice.
You suck.
Your water.
My first day back at school in 13 years. I'm going in here to sign up for the leaving cert. Even though I've only got 2 months before the Oral Irish, I'm just gonna give it a go.
Desmond.
Oh, Desmond is the first name, yeah. Sorry, okay. Yeah. But Jasoon, but we'll just put
Jasoon. Jasoon.
If I knew
how to spell it. Big.
I don't know how to spell my own name, Askelge. Will
we try it? D-E-I-S-U, Fada N.
Okay, D-E-I-S-U.
Yeah, Fada N.
Yeah. And I have a Fada in my name.
No, you're
I'm delighted.
Something, haven't you?
Okay, that's the end. That's the end of the name that I've always known.
Yeah.
Bye bye, me.
Right.
Irish is a language with a lot of baggage, more baggage than any other language maybe on the planet in terms of the native population of Ireland. There's a lot of issues, you know, it's wrapped up in nationalism, it's wrapped up in history, it's wrapped up in, you know, the Department of Education basically failing. So many people feel that it's a waste of time to learn the language. They talk about it a lot, you know, various different government policies, they have to discuss the language. There's the Gaeltacht. People go to the Gaeltacht every summer. Like, the Irish language is loaded for people, and it's something that needs to be discussed because it's an unresolved issue. And I'm not looking to resolve the issue, but I'm looking to, like, do my part, because for me personally, it's always been a presence in my life, a presence that I know absolutely nothing about. I came to Ireland and people were like, you're exempt, you're so lucky. So for me, I have that personal interest to learn it. But why I'm putting such an effort into it is because if I can learn it properly, then I can really have a say in what is essentially an exceptionally important thing to discuss in this country. In Connemara, they don't give a shit about grammar. They don't even give a shit about Irish, really. They just use Irish structures and try to get as much English into it as possible. They just take English words and they put shavus on them whenever they fucking can. Even when they curse, you know, they don't call you a bastard, they call you a wastard. Anyway, it doesn't really matter. They just work the shavu on the English words. But, you know, the most important thing in Connemara for them, I think, about me learning Irish from day one, it wasn't about the grammar, it wasn't about the folklore, it was all about the blas. That's what they said to me. It's all about the blast. They didn't give a shit if I said it right once I sounded like I fucking meant it, you know? Once I worked that, that was the first. They said, you're not saying it right until you can see it. So I've stopped watching TG4 to get the blast, and I've started watching Al Jazeera because it seems they exaggerated more, you know, the ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-
Here are some useful words for quantities of food.
Potta uachtar.
Potta uachtar.
Tub of cream.
Bolog aran.
Bolog aran.
A loaf of bread.
Schliss aran.
Schliss aran.
A slice of bread.
Schliss. I was talking to this guy, Michal of Fuil, on the phone. Somebody told me he's doing some interesting stuff with the language on the internet and on, like, CD-ROM and stuff. He runs one of the Irish colleges, Kalash the Lurgan.
Hello, Des.
Hi, Michal. Des, I was talking to you on the phone earlier.
I'm sure, Des. Míle fáilte. Fáilte go Connemara.
Take your time. Don't be afraid to make mistakes anyway. Whatever.
Okay,
don't. You're not shy, I hope.
Yeah, no, I'm not shy. Oh,
that's good, that's
Thanks.
Good.
Kéchi will too.
Táim ag amach ar a maith.
Kéchi will too. Táim ag amach ar a maith.
Kéchi will too. Táim ag amach ar a maith.
Gur a maith.
What happened, like, agat? I know this word, agat. I hear it all the time. And I've come to Connemara and...
No, well, okay, the G is silent.
That's not universal, though.
No, I suppose in Kerry they'd say agat.
Agat, yeah. Because you hear that a lot, agat.
Yeah. No, but here, but you're in Connemara now.
It is a language that is created to fuck with people. That is a fact. I mean, how many ways in a language can you say the number two?
I don't know how many you need. I thought you only needed one way to say two. You learn a language. One, two, three. Uno, dos, tres. In Irish, hain, do, tree. Two is doe. Doe is two. It's also a deer. Let's not get confused. Doe is two. Bingo. I have it. Two, the number two. I have it. Bingo. In my pocket, I have doe euro. It's gore, you fucking agent. It's gore. It's not door. It's gore. Spelt D-H-A Fada, by the way. Explain to me how the fuck that is. Gore. Because it's not even gore. It's actually, it has to come from down here somewhere. You know, like, half of the pronunciations in Irish come from the painful part of your soul. It's like, So I have gore brothers. Bert, you fucking agent. Bert. Who the fuck is Bert, okay? There's no fucking Bert in McClan, okay? And if there's a Bert in McClan, then where the fuck is Ernie? Okay, stop confusing me.
The most important thing, I think, is the fact that all the debate and argument aside, the language is definitely a unifying thing for the community here. If anything is dying in modern Ireland, and I'm not a real critic of the changes in modern Ireland, but if anything is dying, you would definitely feel that a sense of community is dying. Whereas here, you don't feel that at all. But at the same time, I don't feel like people feel like they have a burden that they're carrying this thing on. You know, in fact, I'm surprised at the amount of people who don't really care. It's just something that they do. It's not something that they think about.
It's a crazy language. I love. But what if you don't believe in God? And they said, well, then you can't have any hope.
Bawalam canig, a papernuchtan led hull.
Kim papernuchta bawalet.
Erenach Times.
Oh, touch it in me here.
Oh, no, the Erenach Independent.
On Papernuch's blog.
Yeah.
But me might be the one who said
that. Gomeleshkel, Asperla, Tabron Orum.
Oh, Neil Ain Berla Gum. Tabron Morum to Neil Ain Berla Gum. Thinking to a shin.
Neil Ain Berla.
Agum.
Can I?
Boalum.
Yeah, Boalum. Ask you.
Boalum era ort.
Boalum era ort. What certain things are, Askelia.
Or the
example, Cardisha.
Shint Sousal Bilk. Sousal Bilk.
Strauss.
Shint. Breach the Bilk.
Breach the Bilk. So small trousers.
What's that? Breach
the Bilk.
Breach the Bilk. That's the high tea was there.
Yeah.
Digging toe.
Digging toe. Me higgin'. Okay, it's pity we can't all look like that. You have one of the most eclectic collections of things in a shop.
Tabulor, but the exola the shopper of it.
Exola.
Exola.
It's just amazing to have something like this out your window that's constantly changing. You know, you never really get sick of looking at it because it always looks feckin' different. Like, to be honest, one day, some days it looks like paradise and other days it looks like hell. Like, genuinely, some days it's like feckin' the Bahamas, you know, and the sun and just, like, you feel like from this window you can actually see the seabed. It's so feckin' clear, you know. It just depends. Brahin Shay. Brian Shay.
Don't tell me. Who am I? Niakamet. Niakamet. Niaka. Oh, there they are. Kevade, Nassel. Just them?
There you go, lads.
Bon appetit. Ihe, yeah? Ihe. Ihe, an asshole. Ihe. Mana or feared?
Oh, she's burin.
Burin?
Burin, they're female.
Oh, they're female.
Like, for a boy, yeah, to she's ferin.
Ferin and burin. They're both female. That's why they like the toast.
Ach, gee, Des, for God's sake, Des. But do not paint to Chidel Irmala. Neither would you get a thorn or a faint to him, don't you?
Don't paint the floor?
Yeah, knock her paint her nurler, my friend.
I will do showing off.
Huh?
Basically, we're just getting the Kalash the Lorgan Ray for the new summer season of learning Irish. You know, earlier, when I first came in February, Micheál asked if I would help him out. So basically, I'm working for Foghlaim. I'm working for learning. So I'm helping Micheál paint, and he's, you know, and to be honest, it's been a great help the last couple of days. But I don't want to get too heavy into it, but does it mean that you have more of a right to consider yourself from a place if you can speak the language?
Well, I suppose what you want to say is that you feel some way that you want to make a meaningful connection with the Gaelic culture, that you feel in some way that it's part and parcel of your whole being.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I mean, it sounds almost a bit heavy, but that would definitely be it.
But that, I suppose, that is the strongest motivation and the best motivation for anyone to learn Gaelic or to learn any language that's their own language by right.
The fucking curriculum for Irish is absolutely shit. But many people think the one decent part of the curriculum is the oral Irish, the screw to bear, because it's actually supposed to teach you how to have a conversation. But in Ireland, it doesn't teach you how to have a conversation. It teaches you how to memorize one certain conversation that if the examiner decides to go down a different road, you are fucked.
So maybe I'll just say I have one brother.
Yeah.
Bader, yeah.
Bader.
Because then I don't have to describe the two of them. So I'll say, so, Cahir.
Cahir.
Cahir. Dinna.
In
McClan. In you. Oh, Tasha, on tragedy walk.
And I'm doing the leaving cert today. Oh, yeah. I've done it twice already, man. Like, and now I'm doing the leaving. I got my uniform on. You know, I put my uniform on today, I swear to God, like, my stomach turned. I felt weird, man. I got really nervous and, like, my whole personality changed, you know? It was, like, weird. I expected pimples to just start to come out in my face. You know, it was really odd. I mean, I'm only doing the foundation level now because I don't know any of the poetry and anything, so I couldn't sit the ordinary level. I'm still really nervous. Like, I kind of wish that I didn't take this on at all. Like, I feel like, you know, came far. Why did I bother, you know? I just don't want to look like a fucking idiot, you know?
The nerves are long. Liz, what's the rules?
Grandma. Right, Des Bishop. Digwit.
Des Murgwit.
Come on. Can you undot Brehe at Hogwit?
Can you undot Brehe?
Brehe, undot a Rugum too.
Oh, well, Rugu agus tugu I nu arach, mate.
I nu arach, ma. I was cain dota a rishu sin.
Oh, cain dota, good. Good, the gomanashkeel, gomanashkeel. The tame, uta, jahar, awan, agus, neil ein drefer, agam.
Cain ish ein drefer, at all good. Cain ish.
Mo yeher, oh, cain ish mo yeher.
The grahar, she.
Oh, yeah, mo jahar, fikia nui, Fikini dish. Fikini blin a dish.
Come on. Are we chin is oiga? No, it's shinna not us.
Is dinner oiga. Is nis nis shinna the misha. You know, they're just having the crack, right? And then I'm walking in and go, share, a neil, a share, a neil, a share.
Thank you.
last couple of days, I've been listening to more and more of the music. And I just feel it's a big part of the whole spending time down here. So that was a great little introduction. I might try to, like, pick up an instrument while I'm trying to pick up the language or something, you know? Because, you know, you're standing next to a guy with a big beard like that. Just helps you feel part of the whole thing a little bit more. Start to get the impression that even though you're a visitor, that you're a very welcome visitor, you know. Whereas before you feel like people are being hospitable, now you feel like they couldn't give a shit, you know.
Come on!